strong women, just like I think we are strong women. So, as most of you probably know, most of us have been going to this church for basically our entire lives. And throughout our time here, we've learned skills in leadership, friendship, and kindness from all of the many amazing women here. As young girls, we were in need of good role models to help us mold into the people we are today. And we will continue growing and changing with their influence. One of these women is Mrs. Mayo. And if she wasn't here, today would not have happened at all. Without her work and dedication to us in this church, we would be nowhere. So thank you for everything you have done for us and everything you will do in the future.
So I'm a freshman in high school, and with that it comes with tons of stress, with all the tests, finals, AP tests, and everything. So being able to come to church on a Sunday, go and do kids' night out every Tuesday, helps me relieve my stress, gives me a chance to feel relaxed. A person who helps me become relaxed, feel relaxed, is Mrs. Moffitt. I've known her since I was in kindergarten. She's like a second mother to me, and every time I see her at church or at kids' night out, she just helps me relieve my stress.
So I really like keeping things, whether it's a card, a picture, a hat, I keep things. So I have a few things I'd like to share with you this morning from strong women in our church. I'll start with the hat, because I'm sure you noticed. Miss Dorothy actually made this hat. She normally comes to the service, but she has inspired me a great deal. And one year for Easter, she made this hat for herself. She said she worked really hard on it all the night before, and then she wore it on Easter, and she said she felt a little funny wearing it. She wore it anyway because she worked really hard on it, and to me that was an amazing thing, and I thought it was beautiful. I couldn't believe she made it, and so I was just like, it looks amazing on you. Grace and I were so impressed that she made this hat, so we wanted to come up and tell her, and we did, and she was like, no, you're wearing that nice pink dress, the one I'm wearing today, and she was like, I think this hat would look amazing on you. So she wanted me to try it on so we could take a picture together. So I did, and she was like, you know what? That hat looks twice as good on you as it does on me. You, why don't you take it? And then you can wear it to parties in the future. And so I wanted to wear this hat as a thank you to her today for teaching me generosity and teaching me hard work skills. And that no matter what you think of something you do, you should be proud of it. And so I want to thank her. She's been like a second mom to me, and it's always nice coming here and seeing her. And then I have a few other people I want to thank. So this may look like a silly piece of torn up paper with some colors on it, but it is a lot more than that to me. Miss Arabella made this for me. You just heard her sing. She made this for me for my choir binder, because my choir binder is all black. She thought it was boring, so she wanted to make me a picture. And all throughout this year, every time I open my binder, I see this picture, and it makes me happy, because I think of just how happy she was to color and make me a picture. And even a small child can be a strong woman in teaching others happiness. And then one more quick one. As many of you know, we worked really, really hard on Operation Christmas Child, and the woman that started that was Tanya Bowman. She and her family moved to Washington not too long ago, but without her, I never would have received this letter. This letter is from Zimbabwe. A girl lives there, and she got one of my shoeboxes, and she wanted to thank me. So she sent me this letter, and I've kept it ever since, and it means so much to me. And I learned from her and from Ms. Bowman that giving is one of the most important things you can do. And then I just want to end with a card that Ms. Donna Bell gave me. But it said she needed a hero, so she became one. And every single one of these women that are in this church today, that were here earlier, and that have moved on from this church, have been a hero to themselves and to every little girl that runs around this church, no matter how old they are. And I just wanted to thank every single one of them.
So I think that the main theme you can see is that we have a lot of moms in this church that don't serve in the traditional, like, parental mom role. I personally feel like I have so many moms in this church, and I just wanted to take a minute to acknowledge all of them. So, to the mom who gave me my first Bible and stressed the importance of connecting with God every day, to the moms who taught me in Sunday school and children's church and started me on the path of learning what Jesus had done for me, to the moms who led me in youth group and taught me how to get work done while still having a ton of fun, to the moms who led me in choir and helped me find my passion for music, to the mom who introduced me to every new person in the church and showed me how to be a welcoming party of one to a friend that I just hadn't met yet, to the moms who led me to a foreign country and showed me that it is better to give than to receive, to the moms who were my standing grandmothers, always ready with a welcoming hug and encouraging word, to the moms who have fed me at kids' night out, church luncheons, and fellowship events, and taught me how to have a heart for hospitality while serving others, to the moms who have moved away but still keep in touch, and to those who have passed on but leave their legacy behind, to the mom who has been the most ardent supporter of Fellowship of the Cross and demonstrated generosity by helping with every request that we had, to the mother's helpers, the older kids I looked up to, who loved me like a sister and showed me the ins and outs of growing up. A la madre que me ayudó con mi español y me enseñó que el idioma no es una obstáculo para el amor. To the newest moms who looked out for me in Lynchburg and helped me balance my faith with my schoolwork in my first year of college. To the moms who on a moment's notice opened their doors to me and showed me that a family is not defined by blood. And to my mom, who encouraged me to be myself by letting me go to the grocery store dressed as Minnie Mouse, who shared her love of music through 8-hour sing-alongs to Virginia, who supported every activity I was in and didn't complain about being my personal taxi, and who taught me that no matter how crazy life gets, my faith and my family are forever. To each of these strong women, I want to say thank you. I'm blessed to have you be a part of my life. I know for a fact I would not be the person that I am today without being a daughter of all of the Supreme United Methodist Church moms.